very excited to bring you the past CAPM in 21 days study guide and the course. This is an online course. I just want to give you a preview of the online course. So here it is on the LMS at kavitasharma.net. So let's get started and see what's going on here. So the moment you are in the course, and I know a lot of you have this fear of PMBOK processes and so on. So this is a glimpse to just to show the how easy it is to understand the processes, process chart and so on. I would want to show you this thing, which is a glossary. This is added here. So anytime when you come to the course, you would be able to see one term. It's easier for you to remember that term. And that's the reason, you know, let's say I change this, you get another term. So you would know, you know, what is planned procurement. So one thing at a time makes things easier to remember and recall. So that's from the process glossary. It's here. Now here are few of the things which I'm very proud to present to you. The first one is match the process with the knowledge area and the process group. Now for this, a lot of people have this problem of, you know, how do I know which process belongs to which knowledge area? Understand, you don't have to remember all the 49 processes. Nobody is going to ask you name of the 49 processes. What may come in the CAPM exam is which process belongs to which knowledge area or which process group. So this is just to give you hints and help you. Let's see conduct procurement. So you have a keyword called procurement here. So obviously the knowledge area would be procurement, and conduct is a keyword. Generally all the verbs which we signify that we are doing it right now, continuous verbs, these are part of the you know, executing process groups. So conduct is one of that. Don't worry about collect is planning. So you need to just practice for some time and you would be able to know. So conduct is executing. Collect requirements, you tell me. Requirement belongs to scope, and collect belongs to planning, I told you guys before. Control belongs to monitoring and controlling, process group, and cost is the knowledge area. So this is very, very simple. Sequence activity, we sequence them at the time of planning, and it is part of schedule. So I'm not gonna do all of them. You can keep doing them later. I will just click on the second one and let you see it. Identify a stakeholder, for example, is part of which knowledge area? Stakeholders. So it's easy to understand, you know, you get the term here itself in the process name. Identify stakeholder is part of initiating. Only two processes are part of initiating. One is develop project charter, the other is identify stakeholder. Manage quality, as the name suggests, you would have quality here. And manage is executing. So this is how you would be able to know which knowledge area and which process group. So I'm just gonna, okay, the last one, close project of phase, only one process, closing, project of phase, whenever we talk about the entire project or phases, knowledge area together, for example, knowledge management or change management, all of that is integration. So so I'm just gonna finish the attempt and see, you know, did we get them right? This is one way, and you can practice again and again and again. See, I've not selected few, so you get the results there. Close is closing integration. Then here we haven't selected these, so you don't get them. The identify stakeholder, initiating stakeholder, manage, and so on. So you get all the right answer and you get the responses to which one is not correct. So this is one of the game you can play. all for you guys, and it's, you know, I'm gonna keep on adding few more things here to help you succeed. Let's look at the next one. This is the sequence of the processes, and this again is very, very important for the CAPM as well as PMP people to know what is the sequence of the processes. So this is very simple PDCA. We plan, we do, we check and act. So we plan first, we do, we check and act, and close. So this is first. Let's look at the next one. Okay, now here it's basically is talking about scope management. Create WBS, collect requirement, define scope, control scope, validate scope. So which one comes first? Collect requirement comes first. Then what do? We go ahead and define the scope. One person cannot do the work themselves, so we create smaller manageable items called create WBS. Now in the PMBOK, you would have validated scope first, but how do the processes getting executed in the normal project? We keep on controlling the scope until unless we show it to the customer. So validated scope is when we show it to the customer, and that's how the process is gonna get executed in sequence in normal projects. Let's look at the next one. Now this is spanning across quality, scope, integration, resource, and so on. So what do we do first? So plan, do, check, and act. That's your keyword. First of all, we plan. So we plan, and then we do. Do is direct and manage project work. Okay. My team does the work, so I need to develop my team before they start doing the work. My team gives me deliverables, and those deliverables needs to be tested. The testing happens in the control quality. Now, you won't be able to understand this unless you have gone through few of the videos or lectures, or gone through PMBOK, or gone through a 30, you know, some sessions with the faculty. But these are few terms which you should be aware. This is key concept and you should know. So my team does the work and they produce deliverables. Those deliverables are tested in control quality, and then only I show it to the customer in a process called validate scope. Once the customer accepts those deliverables, I close project of phase. So that's how the sequence is. And there are many sequences like this. So, you know, how do we do schedule vis-a-vis a scope? I'm gonna move next here and next. So let's spend some time over here for see what's going on here. So we have few processes called develop schedule, perform qualitative risk analysis. Do you know what is the, why do we do qualitative risk analysis? This needs to be done or understood before we do a sequence game. Identify risk, create WBS, plan risk responses, and monitor and control project work. So, what comes first? We identify the risk for each WBS item. So create WBS is generally the starting point wherein we have the smaller work, and we create a schedule, we find out what is the cost associated with this WBS, what are the risk with this WBS, and so on. So we identify the risk and then we start planning for risk. We also do qualitative risk analysis, which is, you know, which risk is highest in nature. Should I plan for X risk or Y risk first? All of that is part of qualitative risk analysis. Then we develop the responses for each risk, and each response may result in changing the entire schedule. We may outsource few of the, you know, WBS items because they are too risky. So develop schedule comes later, and then we keep on checking. We keep on, my team start doing the work and I keep on checking whether the work is happening as per the process or not. So we monitor and control project work. We create dashboards here. and take appropriate action. So this is one way of looking at, you know, each of the processes to understand what's going on. And then, so this is a sequence scheme. Again, as I said, these would keep on getting added in this particular online module. Let's finish the attempt and see how did we do. Submit. So PDCA is nice. We plan, do we check and act and close. Collect is fine. This is fine. This we didn't do, right? This we didn't do. This we did. So pretty okay. So let me show you other games as well. So this one is from the textbook called Pass CAPM in 21 Days. Here we match the activity with the process group. Let's look at what is it. So here, match the activity or scenario with the correct process group. A detailed schedule is prepared with milestone. Where do I create this detailed schedule? In planning, a seller is selected. Where is a seller getting selected? In executing, and so on. So again, a process overview is required for you to understand and respond to these process quiz. I'm gonna click on finish attempt. There are many questions here, and I submit. So these two we did, rest of the others we didn't do, so we didn't get the right responses. Let's look at a few more fun games. Now here, this is something which I'm really proud of. These are tools and technique, and understanding which tools and technique is where. So let me comparing to a standard, which tool and technique are we talking about? We are saying benchmarking. So it is learning mode and ideas. Where do I generate ideas? Decision making. Which tool and technique help us to generate ideas? Brainstorming. And so on. So these are data compilation in a standard format. Is it control chart? Is it run chart, histograms, or check sheets? So typically check sheets allow us to add data and compile it. Yes, no, in a standard format, an excellent way to implement a standard. So which tool is that? This is checklist. You know, you have seen those yes and no at the end of certain things. When you go to elevator, when was it cleaned last time, and so on. So checklist. So this is tools and technique. Most of them are here. So let me go back. And this is another one, which is, you know, mix and match flashcards. So this is very nice. Here, make everything disappear. So this is something which I really love. Where do I create risk report? In which process do I create team charter? So what we need to do is we need to look at what are the processes. Plan resource management is a process. Plan quality management is a process. Implement risk response is a process. Here and here. So plan resource management, I create team charters here. See, it vanished because I clicked on the right one. For example, if I click on resource breakdown structure and put it out here, it won't give you the right answer. So where do I create resource breakdown structure? I create in the resources here. Where do I create the risk report? I create risk report when the risk happens. So implement risk responses. Where do I change the stakeholder engagement plan if needed? Here. Quality metrics here and this here. So this is very, very simple. You can play again and then you would get few more and so on. You can play it in a different manner. This was, you know, mix and match, making everything disappear. Or if I want to, I can play it in a different way. I can play it in a learning fashion. So here again, process outcome, project charter is from which process? So I create project charter in the develop project charter. So this is good. Where do I create project management plan? In the process called develop project management plan. Where is the team creating deliverables? The team creates deliverable in the process called direct and manage project work. Where do team file the work status, you know, timesheets? This is work performance data, and the team does it in direct and manage project work, and so on. You know, this is, you can play it in either way. So this is another way to learn the outcomes. Let me go back. And you have other, you know, study material and so on. So this is one thing which I wanted to show you, how to learn processes, process outcomes, sequence, anything to do with the PMBOK 6 process chart. Let me know if you have more questions or you want me to add anything to this. Thank you for listening in, and have a very nice day.